Fallout New Vegas is home to a wide array of characters that introduce us, as the player, to a variety of ethical and political models of thought. Both the humanity of personal stories and grand philosophical endeavors are presented in their own tragic and inspiring ways. One of the most polarizing characters that brings this forth is Father Elijah, the primary antagonist of Fallout New Vegas' first volume of downloadable content, Dead Money. Father Elijah began as a promising, brilliant Brotherhood scribe as part of the Western chapter. Through the years, he rose to the rank of elder, mostly due to his sheer ingenuity and brilliance. However, Father Elijah caused much friction within the faction, pushing people and technologies to their breaking point. And unlike the Brotherhood's traditional goal of technological preservation, Father Elijah also developed new technology and foresaw grand developments. But before this could truly boil over in the confines of the Western chapter, Father Elijah was sent eastward toward the Mojave to establish a new chapter. When Father Elijah reached the Mojave, he found that there was technology to be taken and systems untouched that could be exploited to exert his dominance over the region. Hoover Dam was his primary interest. However, the NCR had already claimed the marvel of engineering. So, though not happy with the situation, Father Elijah chose to focus their forces on Helios 1, a solar power plant that held the key to much more than a source of electricity. Helios 1 had the potential to be activated to arm immensely powerful weapon systems that were being developed before the Great War, Archimedes 1 and 2. It seems this obsession of Father Elijah's was well hidden from both the NCR and his allies in the Brotherhood, as many members did not understand the amount of lives Elijah was willing to lose defending the plant from an NCR assault, or the fantastic advantage to be gained through bringing the facility to an operational state. In 2276, the NCR assaulted the facility, which they dubbed Operation Sunburst. Though the Brotherhood greatly overpowered the NCR in terms of troop and equipment quality, the NCR outmanned them, proving quantity can be a quality all its own. In the climax of the fighting, when it was clear that the NCR would overrun the facility, Father Elijah vanished. Those in the Brotherhood assumed he had been killed in the fray and retreated to the Hidden Valley Bunker, where they are found based in 2281 during the events of Fallout New Vegas. Father Elijah's unwillingness to share his true ambitions in Helios 1 and his leave during the battle with the NCR was very characteristic. Just like in the West Coast chapter he had departed from, Father Elijah refused to develop any meaningful relationships with those around him, and placed his trust not in others, but in his own genius and a brutish commitment to his ambitions, regardless of the human cost. One exception is to a young woman he mentored, Veronica Santangelo, whom he developed a strong relationship with. She was one of the only members of the Brotherhood that seemed able to connect with him, and he taught her much of what he knew and how to approach both technology and tradition with a questioning prod. He was a teacher, but also took the place of her family, and specifically requested she came with the new chapter moving east. But as they moved east, Father Elijah's fondness of breaking traditional thought increased, as did his utilitarianism. In her own words, Veronica describes the difference between what Father Elijah taught her and what she learned from him.
Elijah could look at an old device and immediately understand what made it work. And he could see its potential, where it fit with other technology. It's not something he could teach, but he tried with me. Some of it stuck. But that's what he taught me. You ask what I learned from him. I learned what I don't want to become. In the end, there was just him and his vision. Nothing and no one else.
When Father Elijah fled at the battle for Helios 1, he left the Mojave altogether. It was clear to him that the Brotherhood, in its current state, was destined for destruction. So he took the same methodical, dissecting, and progressive approach of problem-solving to the wasteland as a whole, to find and develop the technology required to rescue the Brotherhood and claim the Mojave Wasteland under a blank slate. After fleeing from Helios 1, Elijah trekked through the divide and beyond to Colorado, where he spent time among the Ciphers, a group of people who dedicated themselves to the memorization of mathematics and schematics. Not much is known canonically about this group, but a fantastic look at their scheduled appearance in the defunct Fallout Van Buren is looked at in depth by Retcon Raider, whose video you can find on screen and in the description. Elijah also managed to find his way to the Great Empty, a wonderland of technological development that Father Elijah exploited greatly to access the tech he would need to reclaim the Mojave. Here he learned of the Sierra Madre and prepared some of the technology from the Great Empty to go about its exploration. He believed the legends presented to him by another courier about the Sierra Madre, that in its depths was held the ultimate treasures with which he could achieve his goals. He heard the broadcast of the woman's voice and believed in the message Sinclair held in store, that there could be a true chance to begin again. While he was still at Big Mountain, however, there was an attempt on his life at the hands of Christine Royce, a member of the Circle of Steel, a subgroup of the Brotherhood tasked with internal affairs. She was sent to hunt down Elijah after news of his crimes across the wasteland became known. Father Elijah trapped her and made his escape, but he also recognized his would-be assassin, Christine Royce, Veronica's former love, who he himself had arranged for their relationship's ensured demise. So it was Father Elijah left the Big Empty and returned to the Mojave to set up a temporary base in an abandoned BOS bunker, where he studied remnants of the Sierra Madre Casino and Resort, such as the ever-present Poisonous Cloud. Once Father Elijah reached the Sierra Madre, he realized the true potential it held. Many of the technological wonders he had encountered or found mentioned at Big Mountain were present there. The cloud, while poisonous, had preserved the casino and its technology. The holograms proved to be near invincible security measures, and the most miraculous of all, the Sierra Madre vending machines, molecular assemblers with the ability to produce nearly any conceivable object. Father Elijah needed to enter the casino itself, however, to access what he believed were the true secrets and archives of the Sierra Madre. He decided to employ explosive slave collars he had fine-tuned while at the Big Empty to force teams to do his will. He tried many times, but the teams always turned on each other or failed. It's not until the courier and three others are linked together that he is able to just barely force a team to remain cohesive enough to pull off the heist. This is the happenings of Fallout New Vegas' first DLC, Dead Money. And after its events, there appear four potential endings for Father Elijah. He's killed in a fight with the courier, kills the courier and attempts to continue his conquest of the Sierra Madre, is trapped in the casino's vault to die alone, or partners with the courier to seek out his dreams of a Mojave wasteland emptied of its inhabitants and ready to begin again. This brings up the question of Father Elijah's true intentions when he returns to the Mojave. At first, it seems Father Elijah meant to return and aid the Brotherhood and defeat the NCR, fending them off from the Mojave wasteland so that the technologies there could be taken into the Brotherhood's control. However, it is apparent that by the time Dead Money occurs, some 5 years after the Brotherhood's defeat, that Elijah plans on wiping the Mojave free of his previous chapter too. It's not clear when this decision solidified, or whether his allegiance to the Brotherhood was ever a reality, or if he just used his authority and the people within to accomplish his own will. Perhaps this occurred when Elijah realized he was being hunted in the Big Empty, or when he realized the potential of the technologies he found at the Sierra Madre. It's never truly apparent his long-term goal. Does Father Elijah truly intend on starting a new world order in the Mojave, or does he simply intend to use it as his personal sandbox in fulfillment of vengeance? What does a nation built by Father Elijah look like? He certainly has all the technologies required to both destroy the nations that are attempting to take it and reinstate his own. Once the slate of the Mojave is clean and he progresses into the NCR's westward grip, Does he simply send the cloud into any potential threat or society? All of these possibilities are alluded to in dialogue or ramblings by the man himself, but there's no clear answer. Father Elijah remains a cold amalgam of undefinable and limitless ambition. Veronica, the person closest to him, and the only person close to him at all, sums up Father Elijah best. It was only Father Elijah and his vision. There was nothing and no one else. In a way, it's possible to feel at least tinges of sorrow for Elijah. He was so desolate of true human connection, he could only cling to the vision he had. His story is a story of a man truly alone. However it was, he came to be that way. But in the same breath, his actions spell out the tragedy he plays out. What he perceives as the ultimate good, the ultimate goal, costs him everything that could ever bring true meaning to his life, relationships. Father Elijah irrefutably causes pain, torment, and belittlement to anyone he encounters. People are objects to him. But when he heard the call of the Sierra Madre, promising the opportunity to start over, it's possible that a small remnant of conscience clung to the possibility that even a poor sinner like he could begin again.